YouTube, today at powerjackrepair.org we got a 300E Samsung and P300E5A. I got a sore throat, so not gonna talk too much. I'm just gonna show you how to replace this piece right here. You see it's cracked and broken, but it looks alright, functioning fine. This piece, however, right here looks pretty damaged, because you can see two pins. Once you can see two pins means the jack is broken. You should see a black round circle in there if the jack isn't broken. You see somebody was trying to pull it out and they messed up that bracket right here. I'm not sure how I'll be able to fix it, but I will see. All right. Plastic stuff. Should be coming up easier. Some reason doesn't want to come up. Alright, seems like all of them are out of... Should be coming out already. Doesn't wanna come up. Hmm. doesn't want to fit in there because it's extremely tight. Nope. Come on, like that. This should be in place right here. That's the broken jack right here, right there. It's obviously out of focus because the focus is... All right, so here, like that, like that, like that. All right, it's been in it for 8 years, so it doesn't want to come out easy. All right. All right, let's get to me. Let's see, this one is going to be for those guys. Well, I might not even want to remove the heatsink. Hold on. All right, let's clean up the heatsink. That. Good job. All right, now that everything is disconnected, let's see. Okay, all right, and this cable right here. Alrighty, so here we see that the jack kind of spread out on the bottom and it's not going to fit through the motherboard once I start to take it off of there. So I need to squeeze it back and into the same position it was. All right, so like that. All right, that way it's going to go through the motherboard. Next thing is we want to insulate the connections between the parts closest to the jack that are surface mounted components so that they won't be flying off the motherboard. Well, you know what? I think I need to disconnect this heatsink. Just don't want to damage anything else here. Let me clean up the heatsink really quick. All right, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna add some flux. I'm gonna add some leaded base solder. The leaded base solder gonna drop the melting temperature of the leaded, unleaded base solder, and I would be able to pop this guy right out. Let me show you how to do it. Alrighty, so what I'm gonna do here, I'm gonna add some flux right here, right there, and right there. Alright, we're gonna add some hot air to the equation. Let's see, like that. And like that. Good job. Minimal air, a little bit heat, not so much heat to melt anything, but just enough to add some leaded base solder. Alrighty, that was pretty straightforward. Now we're gonna keep some hot air on it, reduce the heat. Let's find the soldering braid. Alrighty, we're just gonna suck all of the solder from the connections. Okay. Alrighty. Okay, looks good. Let's see if any of the components flow off the motherboard. Nope, nothing flew off. Except it seems like that capacitor right here moved a little bit. Alrighty, so the next thing is we're gonna solder the new connector back into the old, not the old, into the motherboard. Flux on top, flux on the bottom. Let's add some solder on the top. All right, so had to change the camera angle like that. Beautiful. Excellent. Let me clean it up and then see if the capacitor got damaged or not. Maybe it got moved in the whole transition. All right, so here like that. Good job. Even though it says no clean flux, still have to clean it. All right, so here we can see that that little capacitor right here probably moved. Or maybe not. Hard to say. Still soldered, right? Well, let's see if we can kind of can't even get to that. All right, let me fire up the second iron. Okay. All right, let's see. Let's reduce the brightness a little bit. Uh-oh, got stuck. I don't think I did it any better, but I think it's okay. It should be. Let's reposition it a little bit. Towards that, like that. Okay. Where it's at, right there. All right. So microscopic, I need to clean everything here. Resolder the. All right. Now that I can see everything much better. All right. Right, looks good to me. Let's clean it up a bit more. All right. Right, looks good to me. Just wanna maybe do a little touch up. Right there. All right, it's fine. Looks fine. And straight. Yep. Very much straight. Okay, so here we got the... Let's test it out. Okay, so the negatives are fine, the positive is fine, and the capacitor is fine. All right, well, it's good to me. Let's assemble it all back together, and hopefully everything's gonna work. Alrighty. Oh, it's okay. They're beautiful. All right, so this is, should be a black screw right here. Okay, like that. Let's see. Okay, all right, good job. Next thing is we got that cleaned, we're gonna put the thermal paste right there. Alrighty, so we got some thermal paste right here, which we're gonna put right here. And just make sure the whole mirror face is covered. Alright, let's close it down. Alright. Here we have the heatsink going in right here. Let's close it down. Okay, so that's closed down. And here we got the fan, which we're gonna connect like that. And fan has the silver screws like that. Let's use the other one. This one. The reason I use the two drill bits because some of them are sharper. Some of them are wider here. Okay. Looks good to me. Looks excellent here. Looks fine right there. Now, the thing I need to do is to see if I could fix this, but I will see that probably not because it's already pulled this guy out of there. Anyways, but we will figure something out. Is this it right here? Cable right there, cable right there, cable right there, cable right here. Right there and right there. Looks good. Exactly. Let's tighten up the hinges because hinges do get loose here sometimes. It turns out they're loose on that one right there. So let's close it down. All right, guys, if the video was useful, please give a like. All of the parts that we use for to make this fixable is in the link below. All right, and let's see, these guys are all connected. I think all of those are the same screw sizes. Okay. Alright, so that's all the screws I got here. I guess some are missing, so we got two screws going in right here. And right there, now I got one more screw, hold on. One right there. They'll have one screw right there, and this guy gonna go right here. Okay, it looks good. And I will try to do something about this guy because you see how it popped out. Okay. So you see, this thing needs to be pushed in. And I'm not sure how I'm gonna do that, but we will see. Alrighty, so I kind of was able to push it in a little bit, but still would have to be a little bit more pushing. And I think I know what I'm gonna do, just let me find the screw bit here. Alright, I can just push right on this guy. Alrighty. Did the best I could. Let's pop it in and see if it's gonna... Oh, shoot. Okay. Wrong way. Has to be like that. Okay, let's push it. Alright, so this is the best I could do here. Let's, yeah, and you see, not exactly the most straight connection there is. Mm-hmm. Because if I... Alright, so I have to use some force to straighten it even more. Let's see now. Almost perfect. Yep, that's the way how it's supposed to be. So good job. Let's plug this guy in right here. Like that. Alrighty guys, if the video was useful, please leave a like. We're gonna put the battery in. Okay, we're not gonna... Oh. Okay. Something isn't right with the monitor and everything else. Alright, so what you need to make sure here is that the pin is in the dead center. Let's measure the voltage at the... Yep, looks good for me. Let's plug it in. All right, I'm hoping for some lights to come on right here. But nothing's coming up. Strange. Nope, doesn't want to work. Well, it is what it is, I guess. Oh, hold on 1 second. What's going on here? You see the needle on the power? Something isn't right here someplace. Strange. Be constant power. Okay, let's see, maybe the problem is the cord here as well. Let's plug it one more time. And maybe wiggle it around a little bit. You know what, let me go find something similar. Oh, that's not even Samsung adapter, that's some sort of aftermarket garbage one. Okay, let me go find my power supply. Alrighty, so here we got another power supply, which let's measure if it works. Yep, it does work. Let's see if this one gonna power this thing up. Yep, we got the light right away right here. And let's power it up. And we got Samsung on the screen. Alright, guys, please. Alright, keyboard works. Please leave a like, subscribe. I will let you know which laptop models I would spend my money on and which ones I wouldn't. Thank you.